Hello everyone, welcome back to this tutorial. So this tutorial is continuation part of file foundation. So in previous session we have studied about how to find the efficiency of a file by using dynamic formula as well as by static formula. So in today's session we are going to study about the finding out the efficiency of file by using file load test. So you can see this file load test is very much similar. You can see over here this diagram. So this file load test is very much similar to the plate load test which we are going to carry out, but the only difference is in plate load test we are going to conduct the test on a plate which is placed on the ground and which is very much useful in finding out the bearing capacity. But this file load test is generally carried out on a pile, and this helps us to find out the file capacity. So here also we can load the entire setup by two methods. One is gravity load method and another one is reaction thrust method. So I hope we have studied these things previously, so no need to repeat those things. So just I will brief the things. So this is a loading platform, these are the planks, these are the cross girders. So this is the gravity load arrangement. So this, as we increase the load, this is going to, this gauge is, this hydraulic is going to push this pile in downward direction. These dial gauges are going to measure the pressure and settlement readings. So in similar way, this is a reaction truss. So due to reaction of a truss, this arrangement is going to push the pile in downward direction. So with this we are going to note down the settlement versus the amount of pressure or load applied. So this is a general arrangement. We will move back. This pile load test is very much simple and very much similar to the plate load test which we have studied. Here 1/5 of the estimated allowable load is first of all applied. With this increment we are going to apply the load. So we are going to keep the load in that instant, that whenever the settlement, total settlement becomes less than 0.02 mm per hour. So till that extent we are going to keep the load and we are going to wait, and further we are going to increase the load, that 1/5 of the estimated allowable load, and we are going to proceed further. We are going to plot a curve, settlement versus vertical load. So we are going to plot that curve, and based on that curve we are going to find out the load carrying capacity of the pile. So this is a very much simple procedure. So if cyclic load test is there, we are going to use this formula to find out elastic compression. So I'll move further. So this diagram we have already seen, so we'll just move further. So spacing of a pile in a group, actually some of the times in a field what is going to happen is a load which was occurring on a pile will not be bared by a single pile. That means the load bearing capacity of a single pile is much less than, even though we can provide a larger diameter pile as well as a higher length pile, the load carrying capacity of that pile will not be sufficient or will be very much less compared to load coming on that particular point. So in that case what we are going to do, we are going to place the piles in a group, two numbers, three numbers, four numbers, like that. We are going to place the piles in a group. So to place the piles in a group we have some difficulties. So what is the difficulty of in placing the pile in a group we are going to study. So you can see over here, if it is a single pile, we have already studied that the distribution of pressure will be in isobar shape in soil mechanics. So distribution of this pressure will be in isobar shape. So you can see whenever we place the piles in a group, so you can see here there are three number of piles. So whenever we place the piles in a group, what is going to happen, the pressure distribution of adjacent piles are going to get overlapped, and this overlapping will be called as highly stressed zone, because of this pile also there is a stress which is coming over this area, and because of this pile also there is a stress coming over this area. So due to which there will be higher stress zone, highly stressed zone in here, and it is likely to fail because of higher stress zones. So to avoid this, what we are going to do, we are going to provide the sufficient space between two piles. We are going to provide the sufficient space between two piles. So what is called a sufficient space? So I will tell you. So sufficient space is when these stress zones will not overlap. So that much distance we have to keep in between two number of points. So we are going to do that. So these are the few important points which I have highlighted. So isobar of adjacent piles will overlap with each other, as I have shown isobars. So these are the isobars of adjacent piles are going to overlap with each other. So soil is highly stressed in that zone, due to overlapping of a pressure. With sufficient overlap, either soil will fail or pile group will settle excessively. So that's what I have told. Due to higher stress zone, soil will fail or else pile will settle excessively. So it is possible to avoid the overlap by installing the pile further apparatus. So there is an apparatus which we can install, so which is called as pile further. So we can keep the piles apart from each other to avoid that. So how much apart we have to keep, and all the things we are going to say. You can see one thing over here, we won't be stopping the pile here and we are not going to construct further. So on the pile there will be a pile cap which is to be placed. So this pile cap is very much costly. I mean, whenever we place these piles so much apart, you may imagine the thing, when we keep this pile so much apart, the size of this pile cap will be very much bigger one, and due to that the cost will increase drastically. So to avoid that, we are going to place, or else the spacing between the piles should be optimistic. So what is that optimistic spacing and all the things are given over here. So you can see spacing of straight uniform diameter piles may vary from 2 to 6 times the diameter. So for the friction piles, minimum spacing recommended is 3 times the diameter. For end bearing piles, the spacing of piles shall not be less than 2.5 times D. So for compaction piles, it should not be less than 2 times D. So these are the standard spacing between the piles that we have to follow to avoid the overlapping of stressed zones. So this is the one example we have given. So this is a Bayes mean spacing over here. So 3 number of piles, 4 number, 5, 6, like that. So number of piles placing in a group they have given. Next, whenever we place a pile in a group, there will be some loss of load carrying capacity of an individual pile. For example, if I place the 4 number of piles in a group, I won't be able to calculate the total capacity of group of pile as 4 into capacity of individual pile, because there will be some loss of carrying capacity of the piles. So how to find out that, and how to find out the efficiency of a pile in a group, we are going to see further. Remember, these formulas are very important, and these formulas we are going to use to solve the problems. So please note down these formulas. So you can see, in case of end bearing pile, there will be no reduction in load carrying capacity of individual pile when we place them in a group, because as they are getting attached, as the tip of the pile is going to touch the hard stratum. So efficiency of a pile is calculated like this. So QUG means load carrying capacity of group of frictional piles. Remember, in case of end bearing pile, we are going to put the load carrying capacity will be 100% as the individual piles, but in case of frictional piles there will be some reduction. So QUP is equal to load carried by each frictional pile. So QUP, load carried by each frictional pile. N is number of piles. NG is efficiency of pile group. So this is very important. So how to find out efficiency of pile group? So for that we are having formula. So ng is equal to 1 minus theta divided by 90, n minus 1 into m plus m minus 1 into n, m into l. So what is m over here? Number of rows. N is number of piles in a row. So theta is tan inverse of dy. S d is diameter of pile. S is spacing of pile. So please note down this formula. We are going to use this formula while solving the problems. We'll move further. So there is some fields rule to explain about the efficiency of piles. So what field says is the value of each pile is reduced by, I mean, load carrying capacity of each value, each pile will be reduced by 1/16 owing to its effect of nearest pile in a diagonal or straight line. So I will repeat it. Just you can see 1/16 of a capacity we have to reduce owing to the adjacent piles in a diagonal or else straight line. So I will just give you an example. You can see if I consider this point, for this pile there will be only one adjacent pile. So for this pile also there will be only one adjacent pile. So owing to this, if I consider this pile and owing to this particular adjacent pile, I have to reduce the capacity by 1/16. So if I reduce it 1/16, the remaining capacity is 15/16. So efficiency is 94%. Similarly, you can see if I consider this particular pile, there are two piles which are adjacent. This is one and this is two. So 1/16 for this and 1/16 for this. If I reduce it, it will be 14/16. So it is 97%. Similarly, for four number of piles, so if I consider this, you can see one, you can see two, you can see three. So three number of piles are adjacent to it. So 1/16 times for each pile which is adjacent, I have to reduce the capacity. So 1, 2, 3 I have reduced it. So 13/16, so ng is equal to 82%. So this is Field's rule. So it is very simple. So we have to reduce the 1/16 of capacity owing to the adjacent pile, which might be in a straight line or else which might be in a diagonal line. So design of a pile in a group. So design, we have found the efficiency of a pile in a group over here. So now if I want to design the pile in a group, so these are the formulas which we are going to use. So QUG is equal to PL into RF plus A into RP. So this we have studied previously. So what is RF? RF is equal to CF is equal, RF is equal to CF is equal to QU divided by 2. So in same way, this formula comes. So in absence of any other specific data, CF and CP is taken as QU divided by 2. So RF is equal to CF. So I have just kept the CF over here. So this P is equal to 4 times B. So 4 times the breadth. So if I consider a square, so or else if I consider any other shape, so 4 times the breadth, if I consider, it is nothing but perimeter. So A is cross sectional area, B into B, that is nothing but B square. So in this formula only I have substituted all these things and I have written this formula. CF and CP I have told you. Next, if however piles of the group are so spaced that they act individually rather than acting in a group, the load carrying capacity of pile is QUN, means individual piles into carrying capacity of individual pile into number of piles is equal to this N into QUP. So load carrying capacity of an individual pile, N is number of pile. So this is ultimate bearing capacity of pile in a group. So ultimate load of pile in a piles group will be less than or equal to or lesser of QU and QN, QUN. So these two values we have to calculate. Whichever value is less, we have to consider it as a ultimate load carrying capacity of pile in a group. So these are the formulas which we are going to use while designing the pile in a group. Next, the type of pile is underrimmed pile. It is very simple. Underrimmed pile means it is a type of frictional pile. It is having bulges at its body. So there might be one bulge or there might be multiple bulges. So other details of these bulges, how to space these bulges and all the things are given here. So it is generally I am calling it as a bulge. Usually we call it as an under rim. We usually call it as an under rim. So there might be single under rim or there might be double under rim for the pile. So diameter of those under rims will be given over here. So this is the construction procedure. First we are going to drill. So there will be a spiral auger arrangement will be there. So after going to that particular depth, so rimming is going to take place. So after rimming, we are going to place the reinforcement and then we are going to concrete it. So this is about the pile foundation. So I hope you are very much aware. I hope you have understood about the pile foundation. These are all the basic things. Further, in next session, we are going to study about the problems on pile foundation. Before going to the problems, I will revise all the formulas and then we will move to the